I'm Earl Stewart. I welcome you to Earl Stewart on Cars.
Rico says, good morning. I'm wondering about dealer quotas. Do all dealers face the same numbers from the manufacturer? And could you please give examples of the number of cars that need to be sold in each bracket?
Rico, it depends on the market, and it depends on the dealer and the franchise.
And their forecast and everything.
They all have forecasts. So if you have a market assignment. If you're in New York City, it's a huge one. If you're in Paducah, Kentucky, it's a small one. If you're selling Nissans, it's a smaller one. If you're selling Toyotas, it's a higher one. But it's competitive within your brand, and it's very serious. And if you don't achieve that, potentially the manufacturer can cancel you as a dealer. And this is one of the reasons why Nissan dealerships seem to treat their customers so badly. And we blame the manufacturer to a large extent because they put undue pressure on their dealers to perform. And they don't support the dealers. The dealers rank them last in the dealer attitude survey by the National Automobile Dealers Association. And so if you don't hit your quota, as you say, Rico, they'll cancel you as a dealer. So huge pressure.
That's right. And to give you an idea of like the range of these objectives or these quotas, in South Florida, it ranges from 634 is the highest quota this month, and it changes month by month. And the lowest is 19. So it's a huge range depending on the size of the dealership.
And that's per month.
Per month, exactly.
New vehicles per month.
That's Key West Toyota, by the way. Yeah. It's only required to sell 19 cars this month.
And Hollywood Toyota is
634.
There's a whole lot of people that don't think about these quotas and the pressure that these dealerships are under in order to meet that quota. And guess what? They'll do anything to sell a car.
There's big bucks, too, if you exceed it.
No prisoners.
We talked about stair-step incentives on the show a lot, and there's big bucks for hitting it and exceeding it. So they're, like Nancy says, there's a whole lot of motivation, one, not to fail, and two, to get rich.
What's the last thing you do at the dealership before you go home, Stu? You text me how many new cars we sold.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
And then what do I say to Nancy? I say, Nancy, we sold 14 cars today, and that makes me happy. When Stu says we sold 6 cars, I'm very depressed. Okay. So there is an intense competition and pressure on all car dealers to sell their quotas.
Yeah.
Great question, Rico.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen.